गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट टाइप्स ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन. देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन, असेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन एंड सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन. असेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन मींस इफ ओनली सिंगल पैरेंट इज गोइंग टू प्रोड्यूस न्यू ऑफस्प्रिंग इज कॉल्ड असेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन. दैट मींस इन दिस नो मेल एंड फीमेल गैमेट गोइंग टू फ्यूज. सो ओनली वन पैरेंट एबल टू प्रोड्यूस न्यू डॉटर सेल्स और न्यू ऑफस्प्रिंग. व्हाट इज द बेसिक कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ दिस असेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन? व्हाट इज द बेसिक कैरेक्टर? फर्स्ट, ओनली वन पैरेंट इज गोइंग टू प्रोड्यूस न्यू ऑफस्प्रिंग. सेकंड कैरेक्टर, नो मेल एंड फीमेल गैमेट्स गोइंग टू प्रोड्यूस. थर्ड कैरेक्टर, नो फर्टिलाइजेशन टेक्स प्लेस. इफ नो मेल एंड फीमेल गैमेट्स, नो फर्टिलाइजेशन टेक्स प्लेस. एंड द फोर्थ कैरेक्टर, द कैरेक्टर्स विच इज प्रेजेंट इन द पैरेंट ऑर्गेनिज्म इज डायरेक्टली ट्रांसफर टू द ऑफस्प्रिंग सेल्स ऑल्सो. So that means these are genetically identical. So these are the basic characters of asexual reproduction. Now if we talk about what is the advantage of asexual reproduction, the first advantage is it's a very simple and faster mode of reproduction. Second advantage is it's a genetically identical from parents. Means it's direct character passed from parents to offspring as it is. It's a genetically identical characters. These are the advantage. But if we talk about the disadvantages, okay, what is the advantage? That the parent's character directly transferred to the offspring. So the positive character which is present in the parent, that is also going to transfer to the offspring. But meanwhile, it is also disadvantage also. If parent has some type of disorder, some type of bad character, then it's also going to transfer to the daughter cells also. So it is also one of disadvantage also and disadvantage also. And second disadvantage, it is not responsible for evolution, because in this only one parent is taking participant, so there is no evolution, no development. So this is about basic characters of asexual reproduction, its advantages and disadvantages. Now we will discuss about the types of asexual reproduction. If we see the types of asexual reproduction, it is have six types of asexual reproduction. First is a fission, second is spore formation, third is budding, fourth is fragmentation, fifth is regeneration, and sixth is vegetative propagation. This we will discuss in detail one by one. So first I explain you about the introduction, what is the meaning of this type, this we will discuss now. First is fission. As you know, fission means division. Fission means division. If a single parent divides and form daughter cells, it is called fission. It is further divided into two types, binary fission and multiple fission. It word itself show, bi means two. If a parent organism body divide into two daughter cells, it is called binary fission. If the parent body is divided into multiple daughter cells, it is known as multiple fission. Binary fission, according to the plane of body from where it's going to divide into two parts, on the basis of this is further divided into three parts. This we will discuss in detail. Multiple fission, if parent body divide into multiple daughters, it is called multiple fission. Example is plasmodium. What is plasmodium? Plasmodium is a causing agent of malaria. So this plasmodium, what is the mode of reproduction? By multiple fission, asexual reproduction. Now, next is spore formation. By formation of spore, this spore helps to produce new individuals. Okay, so only one parent is going to reproduce by forming spore. It is called spore formation. Example is rhizopus. What is rhizopus? It's a fungi. Next is budding. By producing bud, and this bud separate from the parent body and live as a new individual, this is considered as a budding asexual reproduction. Example, hydra and yeast. Hydra belongs from cylindrica family and yeast is a fungi. Next is fragmentation. Fragmentation, if the parent body divides into fragment and each fragment lives as a new individual, it is called fragmentation. Example is Spirogyra. Spirogyra biota. This all these terms you have learned in 9th class. Regeneration. If the body divides in some pieces and each piece is regenerate the rest of the body and live as a new individual, this method is considered as a regeneration, a sexual reproduction. Example, planaria and hydra also reproduce by method of regeneration. Now, planaria is belong from Plectihelminthes. Next and last is vegetative propagation. What is the meaning of vegetative? Vegetative means plant parts. So, if the plant parts is going to produce new offsprings, it is called vegetative propagation. It is further divided into two types, natural and artificial. If it's plant parts naturally producing new offspring, it is called natural vegetative propagation. Example, it can be produced by stem, it can be produced by root, or it can be produced by leaf. Artificial, it means the man-made effort helps to reproduce by using the vegetable parts. This is considered as a artificial vegetative propagation. The types are cutting, layering, grafting, or by tissue culture. This we will discuss in detail. So here is a some introduction about the asexual reproduction, fission, spore formation, budding, fragmentation, regeneration, and vegetative propagation. So let's start with first method, fission. As I told you, fission means division. If the parent body divides and forms new daughter cells, is called fission, asexual reproduction. Only single parent is going to divide and producing no new offspring. That's why it is considered as a asexual reproduction. So first is binary fission. In binary fission, the parent body divides into two daughter cells. As I told, it is further divided into three types. Now how? First is, if the body, parent body is divided into two daughter cells at any plane, example is amoeba. Just look at here, this is an amoeba. Okay, this is an amoeba. First, what happened is amoeba nucleus is going to elongate. This amoeba nucleus is going to elongate. When this nucleus is going to elongate and divides, after that, amoeba cytoplasm starts to divide. Okay, so now first nucleus is elongated and then nucleus is divided, and then what happened? This cytoplasm started to divide. You can see here the cytoplasm started to divide, and then the cytoplasm also started to divide. It divides into two daughter cells. Each daughter cell will get one nucleus. So here at any place, this can be take place on any plane of the amoeba's body. Okay, first elongation of nucleus. So first division of nucleus, it is called karyokinase. Division of nucleus is called karyokinase. And after this karyokinase, Okay, this is parametrium nucleus. Transport means this way. Okay, if the parametrium's body transfer the device and form two daughter cells. Okay, this is new daughter parametrium. But how it's going to divide is not on any way. It's transfer divide. So when the nucleus divide, and the process will be same. Always first nucleus gets elongated, first nucleus will divide, then cytoplasm will start to divide. Process will be same. But what is the change? Now it's not taking place in any way. It is taking place only in transfer form. So transfer form means this parametrium parent body divides and form two daughter cells. This is considered as a transfer plane or transfer binary fission. Example is parametrium. Now the last binary fission is LS plane Leishmania. LS means longitudinal section. Longitudinal section you will see in Leishmania. Have you heard this term Leishmania? Leishmania is a causing agent of Kala-Azar disease. Leishmania is a causing agent of Kala-Azar disease. This you have this learn in 9th class. Now let's see how the reproduction takes place in Leishmania. As I told you here, it takes place longitudinally. Now how longitudinally? Just look at here. This is Leishmania. Okay? And this is Leishmania flagella. Okay? Now what happened? This transfer is started to divide into two parts. How? First, this way. Okay? So now here also, first what you will see? First, nucleus is started to divide. Then the nucleus become two. First, elongation of nucleus, then nucleus get divided, and then cytoplasm is started to divide. And this division now completely takes place, and this is become now into Leishmania. But what you see here? Here this takes place LS. Okay, LS is going to divide its parent body and form two daughter cells, so it is called longitudinal section. Example is Leishmania. At any plane means on another body, at any plane of the body, it can divide into two daughter cells. In parametrium, transferring nucleus divide, cytoplasm divide and form two daughter cells. In Leishmania, longitudinally parent body divide and form two nucleus cells. The one thing is common, always first elongation of nucleus means first nucleus will divide and then cytoplasm will divide and then only you are going to produce two daughter cells. Division of nucleus is called karyokinase and division of cytoplasm is called cytokinase. So this is a process by how binary fission takes place in amoeba, parametrium and Leishmania. So we have completed binary fission. Now come on multiple fission. Binary fission, parent body divided into two daughter cells. Multiple fission, now the parent body will divide into multiple nucleus. So it's going to produce multiple numbers of daughter cells. So how it takes place in Plasmodium? We will discuss now. This is Plasmodium nucleus. This is reproduction. So, plasmodium one nucleus divides